Welcome back, Northern Ontario. We are live here at the SR Centre in Sault Ste. Marie for the biggest ticket here tonight. The Sioux Greyhounds and Erie Otters squaring off in Game 1 of the Western Conference Final. We bring in CTV's Lincoln Loudon for your Game Day Report brought to you by Jiffy Lube. Lincoln, so much star power to talk about in this series, but a great place to start are the two respective captains on each side, Darnell Nurse for the Hounds and Connor McDavid for the Erie Otters.
That's right. Both head coaches of these respective clubs are talking about their depth and how all the teams, all the players on the team really need to step up, but their focus is on Connor McDavid and Darnell Nurse, and those two will be seeing a lot of each other here tonight.
Well, obviously, he's a guy that he can make a big difference every time he's out there on the ice, so I'm going to go out there and do my job.
I just got to be moving my feet and challenging him all over the ice. I know he's going to play me tough, and you know, that's to be expected, but I just got to take advantage of opportunities that I get.
We definitely need our two top players playing well, and Connor and Dylan, they'll be huge to our success. Now, and on the back end, missing our number one defenseman, that's an opportunity for other guys to step up, and we felt that some guys did during this series against London, where Dermott and Radish played very well, but the guys who you know, don't see this much ice time, they stepped up their game also.
It's two teams that are used to having the puck, two teams that are used to playing on offense, so there's going to be some back and forth there in terms of who can manage the puck best and who can earn it. And you know, the best way for us to eliminate those guys, as we always say, is to make them defend. So if we can get the puck a lot like we're accustomed to having, we'll have a good night.
Lincoln, there's so many layers to talk about throughout this series. We touched on Nurse and McDavid off the top. Let's talk about the secondary scoring and how you see both offenses stacking up in their respective scoring.
Yeah, I really think the secondary scoring is going to be very big for the Erie Otters, with Darnell Nurse focusing on Connor McDavid, the likes of Nick Baptiste, Remy Ellie, obviously the OHL leading scorer Dylan Strome. They're going to have to be very big for the Erie Otters to have some success. The Greyhounds are stacked. We know that. Nick Ritchie, Justin Bailey, Jared McCann, Solchinski, Bunting. Like, the list goes on and on. So I think the secondary scoring is a much bigger issue for the Erie Otters. They need more than just from McDavid and Strome in order to have some success against this powerhouse Hounds team.
Now, we know Connor McDavid is a generational talent. Stopping him is near impossible. At this point, what's it going to take for Nurse or anybody else in the team to contain him in this series?
Yeah, McDavid's going to get his chances. We know that. He's an unbelievable player. But Darnell Nurse is being popped as the guy to stop him. But they're not going to do it. They obviously have to do it as a team. It's not going to be one line that goes out against McDavid or a defensive pairing. It's going to be Nurse. Whenever McDavid goes out there, Nurse jumps on, and with whoever he's with. Big challenge for Darnell Nurse here tonight.
Absolutely. Well, that does it for your Game Day Report brought to you by Jiffy Lube. Thanks for this, Lincoln. But there's also another big ticket happening around Northern Ontario. The Battalion are gearing up for their series against the Oshawa Generals, which starts tomorrow night. For more on that, we go now to North Bay and CTV's Claude Sharma. Thank you, Claude. Well, staying on the ice, the Sudbury Lady Wolves continue their miraculous run at the National Midget Hockey Championships as they beat the Edmonton Thunder 2-1 to book their ticket into the semifinals on Saturday. Their opponent is still unknown. And we're going to end this sportscast here at the SR Centre with some ridiculous piece of video. It comes courtesy of the World Under 18 Hockey Championships, where Canada took on Sweden. We pick it up 4-2 Canada, leading. They're on a delayed penalty call, and Graham Knott with the ultimate gaffe. He puts it into his own net. That would cut the deficit to 1. Luckily, though, that didn't burn Canada, as they would hang on for the 5-3 victory. Next up, they'll take on the U.S. in the semis on Saturday. And on that note, we are all done here live from the SR Centre in Sault Ste. Marie. Thanks for joining us, everyone. We now throw things back over to Tony. Welcome back, everyone. Last week, we took our sportscast on the road to Sault Ste. Marie. Tonight, we are live here in North Bay at Memorial Gardens, where the Battalion take on the Oshawa Generals in Game 3 of the Eastern Conference Final. With that in mind, we bring in CTV's Claude Sharma for your Game Day Report brought to you by Jiffy Lube. Claude, what's the bigger storyline heading into Game 3? The Battalion splitting in Oshawa, or the Generals getting that monkey off their back against the Battalion?
Well, Isaac, if you were asked the Generals, they're like, you know what? Finally, the weight off our shoulders. We finally beat North Bay. Going back to last year, North Bay got the sweep 4 straight. And in game one of this series, it was pretty embarrassing. North Bay won 6-1. So they feel relief. No more of the head games, or that North Bay is in their head. But if you ask the troops, definitely they appreciate the split. They did it against a team that's top 3 ranked in the country and a team that was out for vengeance. But since you're asking me the question, I'm going to have to go with the split, especially considering this loud home crowd and the fact that North Bay is undefeated in the playoffs here at home.
Being back home, it's great, and we're all excited. And you know, underdog or not, you know, I think no one really looks at that. I think it's playoffs, and anything can happen. So you know, 1-1, starting a two-game home series. We're looking forward to it.
Anyone can win anywhere, I think. You know, certainly the crowd's a factor, and it will be for the first little bit. But at the end of the day, it comes down to who plays better, and we have to go out there and execute and make plays.
I think that we need to just keep playing a full 60 minutes and get a hard forecheck on them, because they come hard on us too. So I think the more time we can spend in their zone, the better it'll be for us.
Our motto throughout the playoffs has been stick together and stick to our game plan, and nothing's going to change no matter where we play. And I'm sure this place will be loud tonight, and hopefully we'll feed off it a little bit.
Now, Claude, there was a lot of buzz following Game 2 on the non-call on Zach Pertina in overtime, which ultimately led to the game-winning goal for Oshawa. How do you see that affecting the rest of this series?
Well, the troops said they're not going to let it get to them. These are two really good teams, the two best in the Eastern Conference. They're not going to let one play dictate this series that is now a best 3 out of 5. If you go back, Zach Pertina got called for a similar hit from behind in the second period, but they're not going to let them bother this. They're focused now on Game 3.
In terms of lineup changes for tonight, what do you see? Any changes that we can expect for Game 3?
Well, North Bay is standing pat, same lineup as last time. As for the Oshawa Generals, Bradley Latour, a really crafty, speedy winger. Hasn't had the best playoff, but had a great regular season with 50 points. He's out of the lineup, left Game 2 with an upper body injury, and replacing him will be someone not really too well known as defenseman, Sonny Hertzberg.
Well, Claude, we know as well, a big story in this series has been Jake Smith. Today he was named the CHL's Goalie of the Week. He stopped 68 of a potential 70 shots so far in this series. He's going to continue to be a huge X factor. On that note, that's going to wrap it up here for your Game Day Report brought to you by Jiffy Lube. Tonight is going to get crazy. And meanwhile, the Sault Greyhounds, they're in very unfamiliar territory. They're down 2-1 to the Erie Otters as Game 4 of the Western Conference Final goes tonight in Erie. The Hounds won the opener, but since then, Erie has bounced back with 2 straight victories, a scenario the Hounds haven't found themselves in since December of 2014, which gives you a glimpse into how deep this team really is. Now, we know Sheldon Keefe wants more out of his guys tonight, and he's going to need Anthony DeAngelo back in the lineup, but the injury update on his situation, he left Game 2 with an apparent shoulder or wrist injury. He didn't skate yesterday or today. He was in the pregame skate today, and they're still calling him a game-time decision up to this point. Connor McDavid, he's been Connor McDavid in this series. 9 points through 3 games, but the Hounds aren't reading too much into those point totals.
We knew coming into the series that we weren't going to eliminate the impact of the best player on the planet. We wanted to look to minimize the impact and outscore him. You know, at even strength, I think we've minimized him just fine with 3 points in 3 games. There's still some areas of our game that we can execute better on. And, you know, if tonight we're able to connect the dots and continue to do the things that we did in Game 3, but make the additions and the adjustments that we need to, we like our chances in this game. We just got to stick with it.
Staying on the ice, the Central Canada Junior Hockey Championship is off and running today. The Sault T-Birds, the NOJHL champions, got off on the right foot. They were victorious 4-1 in their opener over Dryden. They're going to take on Fort Francis on Wednesday, hoping to improve to 2-0. And on that note, this very exciting edition of your Sportscast is done here in North Bay. We're going to have full highlights of both of our northern teams on the late Sportscast. For now, we're going to turn things back over to Tony.